On October 3, 1967, at a millisecond before 2:32 p.m. local time, Air Force Major William J. Pete Knight hit the button. His North American X-15, one of the most experimental aircraft ever built, lit up its 600,000 horsepower LXR-99 engine. The plane began to tear through the atmosphere, approaching a record-breaking speed of 4,520 miles per hour, Mach 6.7. Every gauge and meter in the cockpit testified to the brutal forces at play. Where the temperature of the aircraft's exterior escalated to an incendiary 2,500 degrees Fahrenheit, the X-15 was melting around its pilot. The aircraft ascended, the blue sky darkened, giving way to the silent, black expanse of space. Violent shockwaves rocked the plane, and suddenly, it began to fall apart. Vanguard. Throughout the 20th century, aviation design embarked on a never-ending pursuit, soaring faster and higher than ever before. From that moment in 1903, when the Wright Flyer defied gravity for the first time, aeronautical engineers fixed their gaze on crafting innovative aircraft that could achieve unprecedented speeds and altitudes. Halfway through the century, the Bell X-1, an extraordinary experimental aircraft specifically designed to push the boundaries of human achievement, first defied the laws of physics, breaking the sound barrier and ushering in a new era of aviation. The resounding sonic boom that rippled across the sprawling landscape of Muroc Dry Lake in California marked the genesis of the age of supersonic flight. From the 1950s, supersonic aircraft became the singular focus of aeronautical design. Within a remarkably brief span, the Lockheed F-104 Starfighter emerged as the vanguard of this thrilling new chapter. Masterminded by the renowned Lockheed Skunk Works, the type epitomized the essence of supersonic aerodynamics. And yet, the relentless pursuit of speed knew no bounds. In a mere two decades, another milestone was achieved. The X-15, defying comprehension and blazing through the heavens at a staggering Mach 6.7, catapulted aviation into the age of hypersonic flight. An ambitious journey. The X-15 represented the culmination of years of dedicated work. It all began with a concept study conducted by the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, the predecessor of NASA. The findings of this study were passed on to both the U.S. Air Force and Navy in July 1954, setting the stage for what would become an outstanding aircraft. North American Aviation was entrusted with designing the airframe, while reaction motors provided the engines, capable of propelling the aircraft to the intended speeds required for these groundbreaking trials. Unlike its supersonic predecessors, the X-15 defied convention with its wider fuselage, blunted nose, and thicker wing featuring a blunt leading edge. Design choices aimed to minimize the intense aerodynamic heating experienced at high speeds. In essence, the X-15 was a dramatic departure from conventional supersonic aircraft. It wasn't supersonic at all. The X-15 series comprised experimental aircraft, typically measuring around 50 feet in length, with a 22-foot wingspan and a wedge-shaped vertical tail towering 13 feet high. Interestingly, the lower part of the tail extended below the landing skids, which would be jettisoned and safely recovered with the help of a parachute during landings. At the heart of the X-15's power was the Thiokol XLR-99 rocket engine, fueled by anhydrous ammonia and liquid oxygen. This formidable engine could maintain a minimum thrust of 28,000 pounds and reach an impressive maximum thrust of 57,000. As for weight, the X-15 boasted a launch weight of 31,275 pounds, which significantly decreased to 12,295 pounds once the fuel was expended. The primary objective of the X-15 was to serve as a platform for testing the conditions that future astronauts would encounter as the United States embarked on its ambitious journey into space. Rocket science. With its distinctive mid-wing design and single seat, the X-15 was poised to explore a wide range of challenges posed by hypersonic flight, including high aerodynamic heating rates, stability and control, and psychological phenomena. The X-15 relied on conventional aerodynamic controls within Earth's atmosphere, utilizing rudder surfaces and canted horizontal surfaces on the tail to manage yaw, pitch, and roll. Nevertheless, once it ventured beyond the atmosphere, a reaction control system featuring hydrogen peroxide thrust rockets took over to ensure precise control. To withstand the intense aerodynamic heating, The X-15 boasted a nickel-chrome alloy outer skin, known as Iconal X, acting as a reliable heatsink. Meanwhile, the cabin, constructed from aluminum, was thermally isolated from the outer structure to maintain a cool interior temperature. And so, the North American X-15 was poised for its first flight. At last, the first X-15 aircraft arrived at the NASA high-speed flight station in the late 1950s. Scott Crossfield, an instrumental figure in its design, conducted demonstration flights. Then, history happened. A prelude. Launching the X-15 was no simple feat. It required the assistance of a Boeing B-52 Stratofortress mothership. Throughout its service, two specific bombers played a pivotal role, an NB-52A, aptly named the High and Mighty One, and an NB-52B, dubbed Balls 8. These motherships enabled the X-15 to reach the necessary base speed of 500 miles per hour, an altitude of 8.5 miles prior to launching. Only after attaining the required conditions would the X-15's engines engage. Mounted under the wing of a B-52, the X-15 and Crossfield were carried to an altitude of 37,550 feet. And then, with an exhilarating release, the X-15 embarked on its maiden flight, a graceful glide through the air. True rocket-powered flights were yet to come, but even in this preliminary venture, the X-15 managed to achieve a remarkable speed of Mach 0.79 during its descent to the desert floor below. However, this initial flight was merely a prelude to the extraordinary program that would unfold. In the coming days, the X-15 nonchalantly shattered unofficial world speed and altitude records, etching its name in the skies. In particular, one record stands tall to this day, the highest speed ever recorded by a crewed powered aircraft. On October 3, 1967, Air Force Major William J. Pete Knight soared at an astonishing altitude of 102,100 feet, propelling his X-15 to mind-boggling speeds of up to 4,520 miles per hour, Mach 6.72. Theory and practice. Throughout its illustrious journey, the X-15 pushed the boundaries of human achievement. It became a pioneer in gathering invaluable data that would shape the future of aerospace engineering. With each flight, it delved deeper into the uncharted realms of hypersonic aerodynamics, meticulously recording data on heating rates, structural behavior, stability, control, and pilot performance. During its decades-long tenure, the North American X-15 found itself embroiled in a myriad of scenarios, each unveiling new dimensions of its capabilities. Across its 199 flights, a select group of 12 pilots commanded the aircraft, representing the best of NASA, the Navy, the Air Force, and North American Aviation. Among these illustrious individuals was Neil Armstrong, a name that would forever be synonymous with humanity's first steps on the moon. The X-15's accomplishments revolutionized hypersonic theory by transforming it into tangible flight. It blazed trails in space altitude control with the pioneering use of reaction controls. Its superalloy structures, engineered for hypersonic re-entry, pushed the boundaries of reusability. It even played a pivotal role in developing full-pressure suits, crucial for pilots venturing into the unexplored realms of space. Through its extraordinary exploits, the X-15 propelled humanity's dreams skyward and paved the way for future generations of aerospace innovation. Paving the way. The final chapter of the X-15 story was on October 24, 1968. Test pilot Bill Dane took to the skies that day, commanding the aircraft to unparalleled heights. With its rocket engine ablaze, emitting a formidable 57,000 pounds of thrust, the X-15 shot forward, achieving an awe-inspiring Mach number of 5.38. At its zenith, it stood 255,000 feet above the Earth's surface. The flight was a microcosm of the X-15's extraordinary tests. From launch to touchdown, a mere 11 minutes, 28 seconds elapsed. The X-15 revealed insights about turbulent boundary layer flow, skin friction, and surface irregularities. Additionally, it demonstrated the pilot's ability to control a rocket-boosted aerospace vehicle during atmospheric exit. The X-15 also paved the way for future reusable launch vehicles by pioneering energy management techniques. Its versatile nature allowed for testing a wide range of experimental packages. The experiments conducted with the X-15 contributed significantly to advancements in various disciplines. These included astronomy, micrometeorite collection, navigation equipment, and thermal protection systems utilized in the Apollo program, which successfully transported astronauts to the moon. Of the pilots who flew the X-15, 8 passed the Air Force's spaceflight criterion by exceeding 50 miles of altitude, earning them the official title of astronaut. While those affiliated with the Air Force received military astronaut wings, the NASA pilots, categorized as civilians, were not granted the same honor until 2005. One of the original 3 aircraft is now prominently displayed in the Milestone of Flight Gallery at the Smithsonian's National Air and Space Museum, next to the Wright Flyer, the Bell X-1, and the Lockheed F-104. The X-15 stands as a natural continuation of aviation's ceaseless quest.